A warm good morning to all. I am Arya Krishna. Our design project is flood tunnel for Trivandrum water logging problem, and it's guided by Mr. Nitin Sir, Assistant Professor, Trinity College of Engineering, and my teammates are Ashtami, Raki and Devi. Overview of our project are introduction, literature review, why this project, scope and objective, rainfall data, flood data, general data, drainage networks, flood discharge in Tampanur, components, dimension and cost, work plan, stormwater management and road tunnel, conclusion and reference. We constructed underground flood tunnel. It's a solution for water logging problem and it's used whenever space is limited. Figure 1 showed the flood in Thiruvananthapuram city and figure 2 the flood tunnel in Tokyo. These are two figures water logging problem in Trivandrum. First is water logging in front of our Tampanur bus station and second is flood in Trivandrum city. These are two figures. First one is Malta flood tunnel and second one is flood tunnel in Tokyo. Literature review of our project is, first is evaluation and roles of tunnel technology in managing environmental discharges in 2014. It is used for stormwater management and transportation that can be discussed in upcoming slides. Second is deep tunnel for regulating combined sewer overflow pollution and flood discharges in 2016. It is also give a better interception effect in wash off of initial runoff. Third is modeling of urban flooding including underground space in Japan, that is in 2004. That is, equation is based on Qc equal to 2.3 bh raised to 1.8. Fourth is Kerala flood, that is financial loss of RS 356 crore. And fifth one is flood mitigation in Tokyo in 2018. This is a alluvial soil depth and most Japanese cities are located in floodplain. Sixth is hydroclimatographic perspective of Kerala flood in 2018. This is variability in infiltration capacity. Last one is 7th, waterlogging parts of Thiruvananthapuram city and overview of Operation Ananda in 2017. It is need for comprehensive program for a long-term remedy of the problem.
In this slide, we discuss about why this topic and why flood tunnel. Our city is flooded in monsoon and need for a long-term remedy. It is one of the effective solution and no interference with surface life and traffic. And it is a long-term remedy. And this is our objectives and scopes of our flood tunnel. Objectives are design and develop a flood tunnel and solution for waterlogging problem in Trivandrum city and the scope of application in Trivandrum city. This is a table which shows the average precipitation in 2018 and 2019. The total rainfall received in 2018 is 821.9 mm and in 2019 is 951.4 mm. This is a bar diagram which shows the average precipitation of 2019 in Trivandrum. A lot of rainfall in months April to November. On average, June is the wettest month and February is the driest month. The average amount of precipitation is 951.4 mm. The amount of water rises every year due to a flood is 0.6 meter to 1.2 meter and the persistence time is 2 to 24 hours. In the case of southern part, it becomes 3 to 4 days. The occurrence of flood is 3 to 4 times in monsoon. And this is the flash flood hazard map of Trivandrum city. The area marked with the red color is the area most likely to have a flash flood. And this is a map which is used to identify a region affected flash flood quickly. This is a general data of our Trivandrum city. Location is 8.5 degree north, 76.9 degree east on the west coast. Area is 214.86 square kilometer and rainfall is 1700 mm per year. The average elevation above sea level is 4.9 meter. And this is the map of our city.
This is our drainage network. There are two rivers occurs. Drains and subdrains are also occur in our Trivandrum city. Natural drains and also there are other important drains. Flood discharge in Tampanur.
peak flood discharge 44.72 meter cube per second for 5 years. Peak flood discharge 72.50 meter cube per second for 50 years. We used a formula is rational formula Q is equal to CIA by 360. As urbanization increases, 50 years storm flood flow is considered for design. This is the location of flood dam. Components, dimension and cost. Main tunnel, 1.2 km long, 10 meter internal dia. Bank, depth of one bank equal to 50 meter, internal dia 10 meter, pressure adjusting water tank length 42 meter, width 80 meter, height 4 meter. Drainage sluiceway, pump facility, water tank length 40 meter, width 20 meter, height 10 meter. Expected cost equal to 100 crores. This is our work plan. Up to this, we are discussed in our previous presentation.
Up to this, we discussed in the previous presentation. And in figure 11, we can see the top view of our tunnel. The main tunnel and the pressure adjusting water tank and other parts are visible. So this figure is drawn with the help of AutoCAD 3D. So this is the model of our tunnel system. The three banks, the main tunnel, the pressure adjusting water tank, the control room, etc. So this is how the system works. There are three banks and a main tunnel which is 1.2 kilometers long, a pressure adjusting water tank, a control room. So the water during the flood season enters the banks. From the banks, this water is carried out with the help of the main tunnel, which is shown in light green color. And then they are transferred into the pressure adjusting water tank, in which the pressure is adjusted, and then into the control room. And finally, they are discharged into the channel or stream nearby. So let us discuss the future scope of our project. Stormwater management and road tunnel. They are used at non-rainy season for traffic. They are reopened within 48 hours after flood discharge. There are mainly two components in the stormwater management and road tunnel. They are motorway tunnel and stormwater tunnel. The motorway tunnel is used to carry vehicles and the stormwater tunnel is used to carry stormwater. And the main advantage of this system is it reduces the traffic jam. It also reduces the travel time also. The figure 13 shows the entrance of smart tunnels. They are in Malaysia. And like we can conclude, the flood tunnel provides sustainable solution for water logging issue. It also provides effective stormwater management system. It is useful in places that are frequently affected by flood. The cost may be reduced by including roadways. These are our references. We also referred Australian Broadcasting Corporation, Indian Express, Malayala Manorama and IMD Data Portal. So if you have any questions or want additional information, please feel free to ask. Also, thank you all for spending your valuable time. Thank you. Have a nice day.